Greetings, everybody of Earth. Paul Muckle here. Today is June 25th, 2011, at 2:41 a.m. I'm up this late because I promised some friend that I'll make them a video with some response.
Yeah, good Muckle.
And
star.
If I don't do it now, I might end up taking star. A longer time to do it. So I just guess I'll just keep my lazy self up and answer their questions. The first one goes to my friend.
I've been waiting for you, my lord.
Bear with me.
I've been waiting.
Go to my friend Osiris King. Right? And May 7th, 2011, he sent me a message in response to one of my videos about Amen, and he says, "Peace, bro. I was listening to one of your videos. You said a lot of things about Amun and him being a usurper. You said he was a common man who placed himself in the position of God. You basically said a lot of things that I would love for you to expound on. I never heard that before, and I would like some more info on it." And I had promised him I was going to answer his question, but I did not. So, my friend Osiris King, my apologies, okay, for taking so long to get back at you. So, anyway, in the meantime, I made another video in which I spoke about Amun. And again, my friend responded. And this one was June 18th. 2011, I made another video in which I spoke about Amen, and he sent me another message, and this is what he said. "Okay, brother, my apologies, and first of all, let me state that all my inquiries are for educational purposes, as I am relatively new to the ancient science. I am not trying to debate with you. No. The first issue I might have is with how freely you throw around the word worship, because obviously they didn't worship in the same way we do today. Most of it gets lost in translation. The mystery system was different throughout the land, and depending on where you were at, different deities were referred to as the supreme deity, because most of the importance was placed on the deeper meaning, like God was present in all things. The actual myth and names was just the beginning. The African religion was the same throughout the continent, just the names were different. All my research says that Amun was the supreme deity of Ethiopia. Hence why most all of the original dynastic pharaohs were the Amun kings. We know that we are dealing with a very long time, officially 5,000 plus years. I think more like 12,000 years, and Egypt and Ethiopia went through many changes. Some things are cloudy, but most say that when Ethiopia was in control of Egypt, Amun was of more importance. Doesn't Amun-Ra signify a union of Egypt and Ethiopia, where Amun becomes the hidden secret force behind Ra?" Okay, so that was a question from my friend. And I will give him an answer to that. But before I answer his question, I'm going to add two more questions to it, because I'm going to use this one video to answer my three friends' questions. My other friend, Mad Killers 566, on May 25th, 2011, he sent me a message saying, "Hi, good day, Paul. I have a question for you. I want to know and understand all you know. The history, as far as you know, is of everything. The reality and truth about the gods and spirits. I want to learn the source that starts all this with its stories. The Anunnaki, what the Rothschild exteriorly are. Really everything, and also what the religions like Islam and Christianity doesn't tell us. I believe part of it is true, but there is much more that hasn't been written. You don't need to answer and explain, since you got your own duties to fulfill. But please, if you want and got the time, even if your explanation is as long as a story, I will take my time to read it and understand. Greetings, Michael, said my friend Michael Van Den. Okay, Michael, I'm forgetting you, my friend. So I'm gonna use this video to answer your question. Now, one more. Oh, those my boys, mad killers. They're real mad killers, you know. they defend me when people come and attack me on videos, right? My boy here, he come and defend me, so you know, that's my warrior right there, mad killer. That's my warrior right there. I don't have to do nothing. If you see someone attacking me on YouTube, he put his face up. One love, my brother. Okay, let me get one more. One more is coming, just bear with me. Okay, this one was a comment left on my channel by my friend Audacity One, and my friend says, thanks for the Psalm 84:11. Have any more verses proving God is a son from the Bible? I would love them. One love. So my friend Audacity One wants to know if there's any more verses in the Bible that prove that God is a son. So people, I'm going to use this video, this opportunity to answer my friend from, answer the question from Audacity One, Mad Killers, and Osiris King. Okay, so this video is dedicated to them and to all my other friends who want to know the truth about the sun. Just want to know what I know. I mean, I call it truth because it's not something that I went looking for to research. It's thing that just came to me. I mean, I could be sitting here going through on the internet and something just pop up in front of my eyes, like somebody's putting stuff in front of my face. I would find a book in my house that shouldn't have been there. I would look up into the sky and see something. I would be meditating. I just get up and put my hand in the Bible and bam. So I see these things as truth because I do not go searching for them. They seek me out. So anyway, so my friends, here's me trying to answer your question as best as I can. Okay, just bear with me. And I'm just calling it how I see. Alright. Okay. The first question I'm gonna answer is the one from my friend Audacity One, because the question set the stage for my the question will set the stage for the rest of the answers, right? Okay. You wanna know about other places in the Bible where he said God is the Son. And people, these are my interpretation. You could take it or you could leave it. Okay? Every man have a right to decide his own destiny. Which means every man have a right to his own interpretation of the Bible. You know, one man have a right to interpret the Bible how he sees fit. It's one that sounds more feasible that a wild man should accept. Not accept, but consider. So anyway, there are many places in the Bible where it shows that God is the Son. But I'm going to start with what I know. Psalms 8. Okay? I'm going to read it. O Lord our God, how excellent is your name in all the earth. Who have set your glory above the heavens. Out of the mouth of the babes and nursing infant, you have ordained strength because of your enemies, that you may silence the enemy and the avenger. When I consider your heavens, the works of your fingers, the moon and the stars which you have ordained. See, people, Psalms 8 verse 3 said, when I consider your heavens, the works of your fingers, the moon and the stars which you have ordained. It doesn't mention sun, people. Just the moon and the stars. Okay? Doesn't mention sun. And we know when it says stars, they mean the planets, because back then they didn't say planets. They just say stars. So we know they say moon, sun, and star. And right here mentioned, when I consider your heavens, the works of your fingers, the moon and the stars which you have ordained. What is man that you are mindful of him, and a son of man that you visit him? For you have made him a little lower than the angels, and you have crowned him with glory and honor. You have made him to have dominion over the works of your hands. You have put all things under his feet. So anyway, the point I was making is that, don't you find it kind of odd that David, the psalm, he would say, when I consider your heavens, the works of your fingers, the moon and the stars which you have ordained, and he doesn't mention the sun at all, because he's speaking to the sun. And I'm going to skip to Psalms 84. Psalms 84, verses 11. For the Lord God is a sun and shield. Okay? That's what David said. For the Lord God is a sun and shield. The Lord give grace and glory. No good thing will be withheld from those who walk uprightly. O Lord of hosts. See? Lord of hosts. People, mark this word. Lord of hosts. Throughout the Bible, you hear the word Lord of hosts. Listen to the Lord of hosts. Now, David, we know David is a man. Okay? Psalms chapter 84. Verses, okay, I'm going to read the whole Psalms chapter 84. I think it's better that way. How lovely is your tabernacle, O Lord of hosts. There we go. How lovely is your tabernacle, O Lord of hosts. My soul long, yes, even faint. Hold on, my Bible's kind of messed up. Okay. How lovely is your tabernacle, O Lord of hosts. My soul long, yes, even faints, for the courts of the Lord. My heart and my flesh cry out for the living God. Even the sparrow has found a home, and a swallow a nest for herself, where she may lay her young. Even your altar, O Lord of hosts, my King and my God. Blessed are those who dwell in your house. They will still be praising you. Selah. Blessed is the man whose strength is in you, whose heart is set on pilgrimage. As they pass through the valley of Baca, they make it a spring. The rain also cover it with pools. They go from strength to strength. I have to skip here because my page is messed up. Appear before prayer. Give ear, O God of Judah. No, give ear, O God of Jacob, Selah. O God, behold our shield, and look upon the face of your anointed. For a day in your court is better than a thousand. I would rather be a doorkeeper in the house of my God than dwell in the tent of wickedness. For the Lord God is a sun and shield. The Lord will give grace and glory. No good thing will be withheld from those who walk uprightly, O Lord of hosts. Blessed is the man who trusts in you. So people, who is the Lord of hosts that King David is speaking about? The sun. Okay. How lovely is your tabernacle, O Lord of hosts. Begins Psalm 84. Then verse 11 say, for God, for the Lord God is a sun and shield. O Lord of hosts, blessed is the man who trusts in you. So you see people, so now I'm going to go now to Psalms 19, and this one was given to me by one of my friends. I forgot his name. He was one of my new friends, and the other day he sent me Psalm 19 showing me that the sun was God. I'm sorry my friend, I don't remember your name right now, okay? Don't take no offense by it, but at least I remember that you gave me Psalm 19. Now you know who you are, so I don't think you would mind that you gave me this psalm. And he said, Psalm 19, the heavens declare the glory of God, and the firmament shows his handiwork. Day unto day utter speech, and night unto night reveal knowledge. There is no speech nor language where the voice is not heard. The lines has gone out throughout the earth, and their words to the end of the world. In them he has set a tabernacle for the sun, which is like a bridegroom coming out of his chambers and rejoicing like a strong man to run its race. Okay? Its rising is from the one end of heaven, and its circuit to the other end, and there is nothing hidden from its heat. Okay? The law of the Lord is perfect, converting the soul. The testimony of the Lord is sure, making wise the simple. The statutes of the Lord are right, rejoicing the heart. The commandment of the Lord is pure, enlightening the eye. The fear of the Lord is clean, enduring forever. The judgment of the Lord are true and righteous altogether. So, Psalm 19 say he has set a tabernacle for the sun. Okay. So the sun is God, because the sun is like he said, like a bridegroom. As Christ claimed himself to be the bridegroom, right? Did not Christ claim to be the bridegroom? Okay, the same thing. Okay, now Psalms, bear with me. Let's go to Malachi chapter 1. Okay. Malachi chapter 1. If I could find it. Okay. Malachi chapter 1, verse 11. For him, no, for from the rising of the sun, even to its going down, my name shall be great among the Gentiles. In every place incense shall be offered. Nonsense, okay. But anyway, this Malachi chapter 1, verse 11 lead us to Malachi chapter 4, 1 to 2. Okay, so Malachi 1, verse 11 say, from the rising of the sun, even to its going down, my name shall be great among the Gentiles, in every place. Okay, and Malachi chapter 4, verse 1 say, for behold, the day is coming, burning like an oven, and all the proud, yes, all who is wickedly, will be stubble, and the day which is coming shall burn them up, said the Lord of hosts. Now people, if a day is coming that's burning up like an oven, what will be doing the burning? Isn't it the sun? If a day is coming where it's burning up like an oven, what will be doing the burning up? It will be the sun. Okay, so Malachi chapter 4, for behold, the day is coming, burning like an oven, and all the ground, all the proud, yes, all who did do wickedly will be stubble, and the day which is coming shall burn them up, said the Lord of hosts. The Lord of hosts, remember who the Lord of hosts is, right? The sun. David told us who the Lord of hosts is. He says the sun. Yeah. So now Malachi is saying the same thing. Okay. For behold, the day is coming, burning like an oven, and all the proud, yes, all who do wickedly will be stubble. And the day which is coming shall burn them up, said the Lord of hosts. And that will leave them neither root nor branch. But to you who fear my name, the Son of Righteousness shall rise with healing in his wings. And you shall go out and go fat like stable calves. So you see people, Malachi chapter 4 verse is saying, but to you who fear my name, and and the Son of Righteousness is capitalized, people. S-U-N is capitalized and righteousness is capitalized. Okay, so but to you who fear my name, the Son of Righteousness shall rise with healing in his wings. Okay, the Son of Righteousness, the Son. Okay, that's Malachi chapter 4. Now let's go to Joshua. Joshua chapter 10 verse 12. Okay, where do I find that? Joshua. The Genesis and Exodus, Leviticus, Joshua. Here we go. Joshua chapter 10. Okay. Let's go to Joshua chapter 10. Verses 12. Okay. Now people, this story, right, was when the Israelites, right, was fighting, I think the Philistines was fighting, right, and there was the people, Joshua gathered all the people together, right, and he was addressing them. So Joshua chapter 10 verse 12 said, then Joshua spoke to the Lord in the day when the Lord delivered up the Amorites. Oh, he was fighting the Amorites, sorry, not the Philistines, the Amorites. Then Joshua spoke to the Lord in the day when the Lord delivered up the Amorites before the children of Israel. And he said, in the sight of Israel, sun stand still over Gibeon, and moon in the valley of Aijalon. So the sun stood still, and the moon stopped till the people had revenge upon their enemies. So here, people, let me read it again. Then Joshua spoke to the Lord. Joshua spoke. People, follow my words carefully, because we have been given this interpretation so many times, and each one of them is false. Because it's preacher spin it, how they want to spin it, to make you think that Joshua was speaking to the God, and God told his son to stand still. No, Joshua was that Joshua people was addressing the son. Listen to this again. Follow me carefully. Get out your Bible and follow it. Joshua chapter 10, verse 12. Then Joshua spoke to the Lord. He spoke to the Lord in the day when the Lord delivered up the Amorites before the children of Israel. And he said, in the sight of Israel, son, with a capital S, stand still over Gibeon, and moon, with a capital M, in the valley of Aijalon. So the sun stood still, and the moon stopped till the people had revenge upon their enemies. Okay, people? Okay, so let me backtrack again. Then Joshua spoke to the Lord in the day when the Lord delivered up the Amorites before the children of Israel. The Lord delivered up the Amorites. Who's the Lord? Who was the Lord who delivered up the Amorites to the children of Israel? Let's hear. And Joshua said, in the sight of the children of Israel, son, stand still over Gibeon, and moon in the valley of Aijalon. So the sun stood still, and the moon stood still, and the children of Israel took revenge upon their enemies. So who the Lord gave them, who delivered up the Amorites? The sun and the moon. Okay, these pastors are going to spin this all they want. They can tell you any kind of rascal interpretation all they want, but common sense. Then Joshua spoke to the Lord in the day when the Lord delivered up the Amorites before the children of Israel. And he said, in the sight of Israel, son, with a capital S, stand still over Gibeon, and moon, with a capital M, in the valley of Aijalon. So the sun stood still, and the moon stopped, till the people had revenge upon their enemies. Is this not written in the book of Joshua? Joshua? So the sun stood still in the midst of heaven. So the sun stood still in the midst of heaven and did not hasten to go down for about a whole day. And there had been no day like this before it or after it that the Lord heeded the voice of a man, for the Lord fought for Israel. Oh my Lord. People, you hear that? People, do you hear that? Listen, people. So the sun stood still and the moon stopped. Hold up. This is too beautiful to cut. Let me start over again. Then Joshua spoke to the Lord in the day when the Lord delivered up the Amorites before the children of Israel. And he said, in the sight of Israel, sun, stand still over Gibeon, and moon in the valley of Aijalon. So the sun stood still, and the moon stopped till the people had revenge upon their enemies. Is this not written in the book of Joshua? So the sun stood still in the midst of the heaven, and did not hasten to go down for about a whole day. And there has been no day like this before it or after it that the Lord heeded the voice of a man, for the Lord fought for Israel. So you see, people, Joshua is saying that never before his time Have God ever heard the voice of a man? This is Joshua. This is the Bible telling you that. So what happened to Moses and Abraham and all of those who came before Joshua? They were worshiping idols. Even at the sun, they were even at the sun. Because hear this, people, hear this again. And you know he was talking to the sun and the moon. Okay. Joshua was talking to the sun and the moon. Okay. And there has been no day like that before it or after it that the Lord heeded the voice of a man, for the Lord fought for Israel. This Bible people is telling you, if somebody say to you people that never have the Lord heed the voice of a man before or after, that's telling you whoever translate this in the 1600 or the 1800 or the late 19th century, he's telling you something there.
There goes Muckle.
Okay.
Star.
They're telling you something, that Christ was a liar.
There goes my star.
And all the prophets that came before Joshua and after were liars, because the Bible is saying here, and there has been no day like that before it or after it that the Lord heeded the voice of a man, for the Lord fought for Israel. Okay? So what have we here? Some contradictions? But one thing is for certain people, one thing they know, contradiction, that God is the Son. And all the other Israeli people in the Bible, you know they worship? Baal. That's who they worship, Baal. And that's why he's saying right here that the one who God listened towards, Joshua.
I realize by the time the storm comes up, right, Jupiter has to be gone. Usually Jupiter being in the sky all
my night, friend,
until in the morning.
There's from other places in the Bible where I'm sure there's where I could point you where it's a God is the Son, but for time
go down
I'm gonna
before the star comes up.
Go on to the next question, and I hope that I've answered your question, my friend. That's the one. Those are the places in the Bible that no man can discredit you and say that God is not the Son. And
I've never seen Jupiter.
People, just real quick, let me ask you all a question, right? Let me ask you all a question. Isn't
that before
in the Bible, right? In the New Testament, doesn't God isn't Christ referred to as the Son of Man? Doesn't Christ refer to himself as the Son of Man?
Hey people,
Christ called himself the Son of Man. Okay. Now, as you all know history, know right? Where did the concept came from of Christ being a deity, our Christ being God, our one with God? It came from that Council of Rome, Nicaea, whatever it's called, that Constantine called with all the priests and whatever they are, the religious people. They appointed Christ as God, our one with God. But in the Bible, Christ said he's the Son of Man. So people, when these simple-minded men, well, they're not simple-minded because they can't you all. They can't me too. They can't us. So they can be that simple-minded. They are simple-minded in thinking that they will, this could last forever. That's where the simple-mindedness came in. Anyway, when these men, right, when these men sat down to decide Christ's divinity, right, they had a vote. They voted. Is Christ God? Is he one with God? Is he Son of God? What is he? But Christ himself said he's the Son of Man. So who is man? Who is these popes? Who is these Roman popes? Who are these Jews? Who are these anybody? Who are they to appoint this man as Christ, as Son of God, our Christ, our Messiah when he tells you straight up that he's the Son of Man? Huh? People, these people hate the truth right before our own eye. Right before our eye. Okay? They hate the truth. Even though the Bible tells you straight up, Christ himself told you that he is the Son of Man. Even he said, but yet we don't accept that. No, we want to call him the Son of God. We want to call him the Son of God. We want to make him God, even though he himself say he's the Son of Man. Wow, huh? So, we are the one who appointed our own Messiah. Okay? We are the one who appoint this man as a God. And all he is a simple man. And that's why we have given our soul to him. And that's why he's getting more powerful than the sun. Okay? Where people, don't you know our spirit can really make? Our spirit can create? If we believe in a rock, and we give out our spirit and our will to that rock, I guarantee that rock will grow. That rock will grow strength and become powerful and control us. Because we are creators, people. We are creators. We create gods. We create these devils for ourselves. We turn night and day into God and the devil. Can a light bulb run without a positive and a negative wire running towards it? It cannot. That's God and the devil. Is it just a positive and negative side of God? That's why the moon have two faces. Okay? The moon have a dark side and a bright side. Okay, it does, and when men use those and give either side its strength, it's gonna turn evil. Okay? So we are the ones, people, that have created this Jesus Christ. And he's not the true God. So that what that means? We have created a destructive force for ourselves. And people, I'm going to be all over the place with this video because I'm answering three questions at once and I'm trying to blend them all together. You know, to make it more educational. So I'm gonna go to ask you all a question, people. I have two sons, right? Elijah is 6 years old, Xavier is 5 years old, right? Now let's assume, right, that Xavier was adopted, right? Let's say I adopted Xavier. He was my blood son. If I was comparing them, would I say Xavier? What I said, remember Elijah is my blood son, right? And Xavier is adopted. Would I say Elijah, aren't you like Xavier to me? Would I say that if I'm comparing them, or would I say Xavier, aren't you like Elijah to me? Comparing them as my sons, I would say Xavier, aren't you like Elijah to me? Not Elijah, aren't you Xavier to me? Because Xavier would be the one who was adopted, so Elijah would be the one I would have to compare him to, right? Am I wrong or right? I would look towards my firstborn. I would look towards my blood son to compare the other one. Now turn your Bible to Amos chapter 9 and verse 7. In Amos chapter 9 and verse 7, it says, are you not like the people of Ethiopia to me, O children of Israel, says the Lord? Listen to that, people. Are you not like the people of Ethiopia to me, O children of Israel? What does that mean, people? If this God of the Israelites is telling them, aren't you like the people of Ethiopia to me? Doesn't that mean that this God of Ethiopia, our God of Africa, who the Israelites claim is their God, are their father, and who chose them, doesn't that mean it's a lie, people? Because if anything, they are the adopted son. Okay? Because the Bible is saying, the Bible is comparing the Israelites, comparing them to the Ethiopians, to the African, because all of Africa was once called Ethiopia. All of it. And Egypt was the capital. Okay? Egypt was a city. Okay? Egypt wasn't a province or a country. Egypt was a city. And Ethiopia, those were the provinces. So, all Africa was once called Ethiopia. So, if this God of the Bible is saying to the Israelites who claim that they are the chosen, okay, they are the chosen ones. They are the chosen of all the people. But yet, the God of the Bible is saying in Amos chapter 9, Amos chapter 9, verse 7, are you not like the people of Ethiopia to me, O children of Israel, says the Lord? Did I not bring up Israel from the land of Egypt, the Philistines from Captor, and the Syrians from Kerr? Behold, the eyes of the Lord are on a sinful kingdom, and I will destroy it from the face of the earth. Yet I will not utterly destroy the house of Jacob, said the Lord. Okay? So right there, God, the Bible is telling you that the Israelites aren't who they say they are. Okay? When I say the Israelites, I don't blame people. I don't want you to think that I'm anti-Semitic or anything like that, right? When I say the Israelites, I'm talking about the Rothschild clan, because the Rothschild clan is the one who come and fool these Canaanites and tell them that they're Jews and they're Hebrew when they're truly Canaanites. Okay? The Rothschild, the Babylonians. Okay? Because people, you gotta remember, right? Abraham is not a Hebrew. Abraham came from the land of Ur. Ur of the Chaldeans. Chaldea is a province in Babylon, Iraq, Iran. Okay? So, Mr. Rothschild is really an Arab with the turban on his head. Okay? He's a Babylonian. And his clan go way back to Abraham. Have tricked these Jewish people, these Canaanites. Tricked them into believing that there's something which they're not. Because the Babylonians, of the olden days, those are the ones who deceived the whole world. Okay? So, that goes to show people, the people of Israel is really Ethiopians. That's why the Bible is saying that, because they're really Ethiopians. Okay? They're not no Babylonians. They're not those Jewish people we want to call them. They are Ethiopians. Aren't you like the children of Ethiopia? Aren't you like the children of Ethiopia to me? Aren't you like the people of Ethiopia to me? O children of Israel. Because they're Ethiopians. Okay? Not those imposters today who call themselves Israelites. And yes, you're an imposter. I don't mean it in a negative way, but you're an imposter, because Mr. Rothschild clan, he have tricked you all. Okay, he have created you all. Okay, I'm gonna prove to you all that this Jewish nation would never existed. People, the Jewish nation never existed. Okay, it never existed. And I'm gonna prove it to you right now. Give me a second. It never existed. Okay, now people, turn into Isaiah chapter 23, verse 13. Okay? Behold, the land of... Okay, I'm going too fast. People, do you remember, right? Abraham, right? Came from the land of Ur. Ur of the Chaldeans, right? Abraham? As a matter of fact, let me find it. Let me find it real quick. I'm going to mess up my Bible a little bit, but... Wow, okay. Bear with me for a second. Okay, let's go to Genesis chapter 11, right? verses 27. This is the genealogy of Terah. Terah begat Abram, Nahor, and Haran. Haran begat Lot, and Haran died before his father Terah in his native land in Ur of the Chaldeans. Okay. Then Abram and Nahor took wives. The names, you know, he took Sarah's wife, and you know, but Sarah was barren. Okay, now. And Terah took his son Abram and his grandson Lot, the son of Haran, and his daughter-in-law Sarah, his son Abram's wife, and they went out with them from Ur of the Chaldeans to go to the land of Canaan. And they came to Haran and dwelt there. Now, Genesis chapter 12. Now the Lord had said to Abram, get out of your country, from your father and from your father's house, in a land that I will show you. Okay, so Abraham came from Ur of the Chaldeans. Now, Chaldea is a province of Babylon. Okay, Chaldea is a province of Babylon. Okay. Now, who are the Chaldeans? Let's find out who the Chaldeans are. Okay. We're gonna go to Isaiah chapter 23, verse 13. Where he says, behold, the land of the Chaldeans, this people which was not, Assyria founded it for wild beasts of the desert. They set up its towers, they raised up its palaces and brought it to ruin. Okay? Assyria people. Who's Assyria? Assyria are the Romans. Okay? They founded the city of the Chaldeans. They are the Chaldeans. So the true people? Okay. Assyria set up this province, right, of the Chaldeans, where Abraham came from. And if you said these people which was not, that means they were not people. Okay? Behold, the land of the Chaldeans, this people which was not. Okay? Assyria founded it for wild beasts of the desert. What are wild beasts of the desert, people? Remember, this is in the Bible, so don't say Palmer is an anti-Semitic or Palmer is racist. Wild beasts of the desert were nomadic people. People who traveled, who live in the desert. Okay? They had no home. So they call them wild beasts of the desert. Okay, they have no home of their own. Why don't they have any home? They must be the aliens. They just are outcast. So they are called wild beasts of the desert. So behold, the land of the Chaldeans, this people which was not, Assyria founded it for wild beasts of the desert. They set up its towers. They set up its towers, they raised up its palaces, and brought it to ruins. So, the Assyrians are building up these cities, setting up its towers, and then tearing it down. Same thing they're doing in the world today, building up these buildings, like the World Trade Center, build up these cities, and then blow them up, flood them, bomb them. You know, it's a game. So that's what the Chaldeans are. So if the Chaldeans weren't a people who are not, who is Abraham? Remember, Abraham was a Chaldean. And the Bible is telling you, Isaiah is telling you, Behold, the land of the Chaldeans, this people which was not. That means they didn't exist. They didn't have a land. Assyria founded it for wild beasts of the desert. He founded it for people who had no home. So Abraham had no home. His home was founded by Assyria. Okay, now, just so y'all know that Palmer is not, this is what I come from Palmer, this is what I coming from your Holy Bible. Okay, now, who are the Jews? Who are the people of Jerusalem? And this is where you get confusion, people, okay? You see Canaan? The capital of Canaan was Jerusalem. Okay, Jerusalem is a very old name. People, Jerusalem is as old as Egypt itself. Okay?
Okay, now we're going to see.
The Jerusalem today, yes. It existed. It's older than Egypt. I mean, it's as old as Egypt. But whose land was it? Remember, Abraham came from Babylon, from Chaldea. His wives came from Chaldea. His sons, their wives came from Chaldea. So the 12 tribes, they came from from Chaldea. Okay, the 12 sons who created the so-called nation of Israel, they all came from Chaldea. These people which was not until Assyria founded their country for them. So
if that's a star, that's Venus.
They all came from Chaldea. So who are the Jewish people then?
People, ain't that something?
Okay, let's find out. Let's find out.
About the morning.
Let's turn to Ezekiel. Ezekiel chapter 10. We're going to find out who these Jewish people are.
Jupiter behind my house.
Because the Jewish people and the Babylonians are different people. Actually, the people of Jerusalem.
That's not a coincidence.
The people of Jerusalem, which is the capital of Canaan. And the Abraham people are different. Because remember, Abraham, all of Abraham's sons, they married their wives from Babylon. So the Canaanites are different to the Babylonians. There's two different people here, mixing with each other. Okay. two different bloodlines. The Babylonians and the Canaanites. Because remember, they didn't kill out the Canaanites. They mixed with them. So that's why the Jewish people today, most of them, they are Canaanites, and the pure blood Babylonians are the Rothschilds, the Rockefellers, you know, the rich ones. Okay, so anyway, who are these Jewish people? Let's find out. Ezekiel chapter 10. Again, the word of the Lord came to me saying, Son of man, call Jerusalem to know her abomination, and say, Thus said the Lord, God to Jerusalem, your birth and your nativity are from the land of Canaan. Jerusalem, son of man, call Jerusalem to know her abomination, and say, Thus said the Lord God to Jerusalem, your birth and your nativity are from the land of Canaan, and your fathers were an Amorite, and your mother a Hittite. Okay, people of Jerusalem, the Jewish people, Thus said the Lord to Jerusalem, your birth and your nativity are from the land of Canaan. Your father was an Amorite, and your mother a Hittite. People of Israel, Abraham was a Babylonian. His wife Sarah was a Babylonian from the land of Chaldea. Isaac was born in Egypt. Jacob was born in Egypt. Their wives came from Babylon. Okay, that's where their wives came from, Babylon. From a people which was not Babylon, but Chaldea, which is the province of Babylon. This people which was not, that's where Abraham came from. And you people of Jerusalem, you Jewish people, The Lord said to me, son of man, call Jerusalem to know her abomination, and say, thus said the Lord God to Jerusalem, your birth and your nativity are from the land of Canaan. Your father was an Amorite, not Abraham, who came from Chaldea. And your mother was a Hittite, not Sarah, who came from Babylon also. As for your nativity and the day you were born, your navel cord was not cut, nor were you washed in water to clean you. You were not rubbed with salt, nor wrapped in swaddling cloth. No, I pitied you to do any of these things for you. You know why? Because your people worship Baal, and Baal believe in human sacrifice. Okay, that's why. Because the people of Jerusalem, they God with Baal. Baal who believe in human sacrifice. Baal who knows Jesus Christ. Okay. So now we know Abraham is had nothing to do with Jerusalem. Because Jerusalem was established way before Abraham even came there. Do the research, people. Jerusalem was the capital of Canaan. Do the research. And they worship Baal way before Abraham even came there. So was Abraham even existed? He was created. Behold, the land of the Chaldeans, this people which was not, Assyria founded it for wild beasts of the desert. Okay, they set up its towers. Although I understand it, it's a fake. This people which was not, Assyria founded it for wild beasts of the desert. They set up its towers. They set up its towers. They raised up its palaces and brought it to ruin. So these people invented this stuff about these Chaldeans, which represent Abraham. Assyria, which is Rome, they created it. Okay? So Abraham is just a creation of some. This is just something that these men, I don't know who they are, these men were able to create. Okay, because we are creators, so we can create reality. They created a reality, people. Okay? And Ezekiel is telling us who the Jewish people really are. They're Canaanites. Now, going a little bit over to, let's go to Isaiah chapter 63 and verse 18. He said, your holy people have possessed it for a little while. He's talking about the land of the righteous, while our adversaries have trodden down your sanctuary. We have become like those of old, over whom you never ruled, those who were never called by your name. Okay? So right now it's telling you, right, Isaiah is telling you that now in the right now today, people, we have become like the people of old, those of old who were never ruled by God, our Lord. They were never called by his name. Okay? Now I went too fast. Okay? I jumped the gun too quick, because that's what I really want to show you. Okay? Okay. Isaiah 48. Okay, I'm going to show you now that the people of Jerusalem today, the people of Israel today, the Rothschild and the popes, I'm going to show you, people, they do not call on any real God. They do not. They do not call on the real God, because his son is God. They call on Amen. Okay. When the Pope finishes prayer, who is calling? Amen. Okay. When these Illuminati and these Freemasons pray, who they pray to? Amen. Right? That's what they call it. Amen. The Rothschild and everybody, they call it Amen. Okay. They are calling Amen in secrecy, but they're calling Amen. But hear this, Isaiah 47. Hear this, O house of Jacob. And you know how Jacob is Israel, the 12 tribes of Israel today. The people of Jerusalem today. They claim to be the children of Jacob. So, Isaiah chapter 48. Hear this, O house of Jacob, who are called by the name of Israel, and have come forth from the wellspring of Judah, who swear by the name of the Lord, and make mention of the God of Israel, but not in truth or in righteousness. Okay? Hear this, O house of Jacob, which are the 12 tribes of Israel today, who are called by the name of Israel. And we know, remember I showed you all in where was Amos, I think, where he said, aren't you like the children of Ethiopia to me? Aren't you like the people of Ethiopia to me, O children of Israel? So we know that Israel is Ethiopia. Israel is Ethiopia because God wouldn't be comparing the Jews to the Ethiopians. And it's Ethiopians that he's chosen. Not even chosen, because I hate that word chosen, but his firstborn. He's chosen. Earth belongs to all of us, but his firstborn. So that means the heir. So the Almighty wouldn't be comparing Israel to the Ethiopians if the Ethiopian wasn't the one he was speaking about. So we know Israel is Ethiopia. So when the Bible said, when Isaiah 48 said, hear this, O house of Jacob, which are the tribes of Israel today, who are called by the name Israel. So you know who they're talking about, because you're the only one who are called by the name Israel. Jacob, you are the only one who are called by the name Israel. So hear this, O house of Jacob, who are called by the name Israel, and have come forth from the wellspring of Judah, who swear by the name of the Lord and make mention of the God of Israel, which is the one who said, aren't you like the people of Ethiopia to me, O children of Israel? That's his son. Okay. But who make mention of the name of God of Israel, but not in truth or in righteousness? So you see, they don't call upon the God of Israel in truth or righteousness. That means it's a lie, people. People, it is a lie. They don't believe it. They call upon the name of Israel, but not in truth or in righteousness. Okay? For they call themselves after the holy city. Okay? For they call themselves after the holy city. So you see, people, it's not their name. Wow. People. For they call themselves after.
Back, people. It's going back.
The holy city. And lean on the God of Israel. See? The house of Jacob, the ones who are called by the name of Israel today. Okay, who make mention of the God of Israel, but not in truth or in righteousness. For they call themselves after the holy city. That means they took on the name and lean on the God of Israel. The Lord of hosts is his name. Who's the Lord of hosts, people?
It's gonna be a
who's the Lord of hosts? Sunrise. David told us, the Son. The Son is the Lord of hosts. David told us. David, who was supposed to be a Jew, he told us who the Lord of hosts is. Okay. Okay. So, David, was David really a Jew? Or did they steal his identity also? People, okay. I'm going to read it again. Isaiah chapter 48. Hear this, O house of Jacob, who are called by the name Israel, and have come forth from the wellspring of Judah, who swear by the name of the Lord, and they make mention of the God of Israel, but not in truth and righteousness. For they call themselves after the holy city, which is Israel, which is supposed to be really Egypt, because Israel is really Egypt and Ethiopia, if you want to get technical.
I can't see your planet.
And lean on the God of Israel.
I know you're moving so fast.
The Lord of hosts is his name. The Lord of hosts is his son. Ra. Okay? So now people have showed you all that Mr. Rothschild lies and the Pope lies are falling apart in their face using their own Bible. Okay? So now, what have we here now? Now, while I was doing that, right, people, I found a couple more interesting things. Okay? We have proved that the sun is God. I'm going to prove to you all again that the sun is God. Let's turn to Job. Now, who doesn't like Job, huh? Which one of you doesn't like the story of Job? You are going to be very disappointed when I tell you all about Job. But not now, in another one. Because Job was an evil bastard. Okay? Y'all thought Job was patient and had faith in God? Y'all have been reading Job right. But that's for another time. This is what I really want to show you about Job, right? Okay. I'm gonna show you all right now. Give me a second right here. I'm gonna show you all. Give me a second. Okay, let's turn to Job chapter 36, starting at verse 24. Job 36, verse 24. Remember to magnify his work, of which men have sung. Every one has seen it. Man look on it from afar. Behold, God is great, and we do not know him. Nor can the number of his years be discovered. For he draws up drops of water, which distill as rain from the mist, which the clouds drop down and pour abundantly on men. Now people, what sucks up water and turn it into rain?
She will travel from east to west. And she should begin.
He said again from verse 24. Job chapter 36. Remember to magnify his work, of which men have sung. Everyone has seen it. Man look and it from afar. What is that, people? Isn't that the sun? Behold, God is great, and we do not know him. Nor can the number of his years be discovered. For he draws up drops of water, which distill as rain from the mist, which the clouds drop down and pour abundantly on man. Indeed, can anyone understand the spreading of clouds, the thunder from his canopy? Who thunders, people? Who sent thunder? Who caused the clouds to split apart? The sun, lightning from the sun, and the moon. Look, he scattered his light upon it. There we go. What scattered his light, people, and the clouds, people? The sun. Look.
There's one over there.
He scatters his light upon it and covers the depth of the sea. For by these he judges the people. He gives food in abundance.
Don't be afraid.
He covers his hand with lightning and commands it to strike. Okay? That's his son. His thunder declare it. The cattle also concerning the rising storm.
Wow.
Now let's go on to Job chapter 37, he had proof that the sun is God, and these men knew it. At this also my heart trembles and leaps from its place. Hear attentively the thunder of his voice and the rumbling that comes from his mouth. He sends it forth under the whole heaven, his lightning to the end of the earth. After it, a voice rose. He thundered with his majestic voice, and he does not restrain them when his voice is heard. God thunders marvelously with his voice. He does great things which we cannot comprehend. So you see, people, when it's thundering and I'm saying, "Speak, my Lord," why do people laugh at me? Why do people laugh at me? And I didn't get this from the Bible. I'm just now discovering this stuff. But I always say, when it's thundering, Lord, speak. So let me read that again. After it, a voice rose. He thunders with his majestic voice, and he does not restrain them when his voice is heard. God thunders marvelously with his voice. He does great things with which we cannot comprehend. For he says to the snow, "Fall on the earth," likewise to the gentle rain and the heavy rain of his strength. Okay? Who brings up the rain, people? Who suck up a lot of rain for it to fall hard on the earth? The sun. Okay? So, for he says to the snow, "Fall on the earth," likewise to the gentle rain and the heavy rain of his strength. He seals the hand of every man, that all men may know his work. The beasts go into den and remain in their lairs. From the chambers of the salt comes the whirlwind, and cold from the scattering wind of the north. By the breath of God, ice is given, and the world waters are frozen. Also, with moisture, he saturated the thick clouds. He scattered his bright clouds. Okay? Also, with moisture, he saturates the thick clouds. He scattered his bright clouds, and they swirl about, being turned by his guidance, that they may do whatever he commands them on the face of the whole earth. So people, who control the weather for the clouds to move? The sun. If the sun is hot, depending on how the sun is, the clouds move about. Okay? This is, he's describing this clock, the sun here. Okay. He causes it to come, whether for correction or for his land or for mercy. Okay? That's what God is doing. He causes it to come, whether for correction are for his land, are for mercy. Listen to this, O Job. Stand still and consider the wondrous work of God. So he's chastising Job. Like I said, one day I'll tell you all the story about Job. He wasn't a righteous man. He was egoistic. Listen to this, O Job. Stand still and consider the wondrous work of God. Do you know where God dispatches them and calls the light of his clouds to shine? Do you know how the clouds are balanced? These wondrous works of him who is perfect in knowledge. Why are your garments hot when he quiets the earth by the south wind? Why are your garments hot when he quiet the earth by the south wind? Who heats up your garments, people? Who heats you up? Who heats up the south wind? The sun. Okay. Why are your garments hot when he quiets the earth by the south wind? With him have you spread out the skies strong as a cast metal mirror? So you see, people, remember the other day I made a video and some of the guys made some videos saying the sky is probably an illusion, like a matrix. The sky is a mirror. It's in the Bible. Look at here. Job chapter 37 verse 18. With him have you spread out the sky strong as a cast metal mirror. Because he's telling you, the sky is like a mirror. Okay? It's a mirror. Something, people, there's a false reality being created here on earth. A false reality. Okay? Someone is shining a false light in the sky.
Yeah, Golden is an advocate for weather modification. In fact, he
and that's what we're seeing. They are hiding the sun. They're hiding the true power of the sun.
Beware that once you
and replace it with just Jesus
weather,
Christ. This is this falseness. Okay. And I'm gonna get into amen soon.
It's the law of unintended consequences.
Let me finish this.
And you may not be able to control the outcome.
So. Job chapter 37 verse 19. Teach us what we should say to him, for we can prepare nothing because of the darkness. Should he be told that I wish to speak? If a man were to speak, surely he would be swallowed up. Even now, men cannot look at the light when it is bright in the skies. When the wind has passed and cleared them. He comes from the north as golden splendor. With God is awesome majesty. So you see, people, it's the sun. Job chapter 37 verse 19. Teach us what we should say to him, for we can prepare nothing because of the darkness. Okay. Should he be told that I wish to speak? If a man were to speak, surely he would be swallowed up. Even now, men cannot look at the light. Even now, men cannot look at the light. You talk about the sun, people. When it is bright in the skies, when the wind has passed and cleared them. Okay, he tells you when the wind clear the clouds away, and it's bright. You cannot even look in this. Look at the sun, people. Even Job, even they're telling you right here that the sun is God. In Job, is telling you the sun is God. He comes from the north as golden splendor. Okay, who rises from the golden splendor, people? Okay, who is it? What's a golden splendor in the sky? The sun. But I didn't know the sun used to rise in the north. So you see how the world has changed, people? Now it's rising in the east. But back then it was in the north. He comes from the north as golden splendor. With God is awesome majesty. As for the Almighty, we cannot see, we cannot find him. He is excellent in power, in judgment and abundance, abundant justice. He does not oppress, therefore men fear him. He shows no partiality to any who are wise of heart. So you see, people, I'm glad I showed you all many places in the Bible where is evidence that God, the Son, these people knew the Son was God. In front of the Pope, in front of the Vatican, they have a monument to the Son. All these obelisks, they are monuments to the sun. But they don't do it in truth and righteousness. They do it with evil intent and purpose. So now, amen now, right? I don't have these notes, people. But from my memory from my studies way back, you know, in during my travels, I came across a story about Amen, and I really do believe it. Amen was an Egyptian, a man, he was a pharaoh. As you know, each time a pharaoh arose, he chose whichever god he wanted to worship. Whether it was Upper Kemet or Lower Kemet, they all chose whichever god they wanted to worship. And they were usually pushed by the priests. Okay, who was really the controllers. Okay. So the priest was really the one, the power behind the throne. So these pharaohs wanted to curry favor from the priest, because the priest was the one who was closer to God. So the pharaoh was choosing the god that the priest gave them to worship. They had so many gods. Then this pharaoh called Amen, he decided that there shouldn't be so many gods in Egypt. Okay. He decided that there should be so many gods, that there should be only, there should be a trinity. Okay. And in a trinity, he should be placed at the top. Okay. He's at the top and the other two at the bottom. So Amen, Ra, and Peter. Peter. So Amen decided that he's gonna abolish all the gods out of Egypt. Abolish all of them. And put himself. Okay? And Amen, Ra, and Peter. Actually, I'm going a little bit too fast. Amen made himself the only one. Okay? Amen made himself Amen Ra. So it was just him and Ra. It was after Amen, Peter came and made himself Amen Ra Peter. So each time a pharaoh arose, they would add a god name to it. Okay, so first was Ra, then it was Amen Ra, then it was Amen Ra Peter came to the Holy Trinity. But before, it was only one. The Son existed alone. So people, look at this now. If the Son is the King of the Natura, right, and the Son existed alone, this God existed alone before all the other creatures was formed, how can Amen be one with God if God was alone? Okay, this Son was alone before all the other creatures and anything else was formed. So the Son is the Father. But Amen came and decided. Amen is basically Zeus. Okay? If you know the story of Zeus, Zeus' mother wanted Zeus to be God. He didn't want Cronus to be God. She wanted Zeus to be God. She wanted her son to be the heir. Okay? So Cronus didn't kill his siblings. Cronus incorporated. Okay, look at the Son, right? The Son incorporate all the heavenly bodies around it, right? All the planets and the asteroids. The Sun hold them in its gravity. And the Sun is at the center of it. So it's look like the Sun have swallowed them up in its belly. It's like the Sun swallow up his sons. Swallow up the moon, the stars, and everybody, the planet. Let the Sun swallow them. He hold them in his gravity. So he's holding them in his control. That's the concept of Cronus eating his children whenever his wife gave birth to them. He wasn't killing them, he was holding them in his gravity so that they could all rule together. But Zeus' mother didn't want that. Zeus' mother wanted Zeus to take the place of Cronus, where Zeus really wanted to eat up all the other siblings and hold them in his power. So you see the contradiction? So Zeus' mother wanted Zeus to be the Almighty, and so they war against his father. Same thing with Amen. Amen wanted to be the Almighty, and he war against all the other gods. Knocked down their temples, burned down their temples, knocked down their buildings, and say he is God. Amen. And then he put Ra, because you know you have to please some people, so you have to put Ra there. So he put himself as Amen-Ra. So he placed himself as the Netter of Upper Kemet, the Supreme Netter. Okay? How can he be the Supreme Netter if the Sun existed alone and the Sun created him? So how could he be the Supreme Netter? So right, you could tell there's a usurpation going on here. Okay? He's usurping the throne already because he's calling himself the Supreme. Okay? So now, so Amun knocked on all the temples and put himself at the head of the gods. Now people, here's proof. Amun, right, is patron god of pharaohs, right? What is a pharaoh? A pharaoh is a man. So he's god of the pharaohs. He's patron god of the pharaohs, god of gods. Every pharaoh was a god. And if Amun is patron god of the pharaohs, he's saying that he's the king of the kings, he's the king of all the pharaohs. Not of the gods, the creator, but of the pharaohs. He's god of the pharaohs because he put himself as the almighty one, the supreme netter, the supreme god of the pharaohs. And that's why he put his name Amen-Ra, because he's saying Ra is he taking the power of Ra and added to his name. So you are right, Amen. He's God, but God of man, God of the gods, God of those people who said it was God, because in Egypt they had so many gods in Egypt. I mean, they had a god for your toe, they had a god for your for your finger. But as my friend Osiris King said, the worshipping wasn't in the way we see it. The worshipping was that they were able to, the Egyptian try to explain something for everything, like a movement for everything. Like if you move your finger, we say it's a nerve. I would say our brain sends a signal to move a finger. The Egyptians saw that nerve, that command that moved the finger, as a god. And this time maybe a bird is a god of the nerve that moved the finger, because what the Egyptians are saying is that that God is a piece of everything on earth that we see. Everything, every human, every animal, every, even the worms, the snake, all of us are part of God. That's what they're showing you. They're saying we are all together, we make one almighty God. So the Egyptians saw this as, not that they worship all those gods. And so my friend Osiris King is right, the worship wasn't as we see today. They saw all of it incorporated as God. But then something happened. The people really started begin to separate these things that worship them separately, like night and day. Night and day, they worship night as the devil and the day as God, Horus and Set. Horus and Set is not no man. It's the moon and the sun, the night and the darkness. The moon have a dark side and the moon have a light side. The sun have a binary. Okay? This is how it is. So what is that? So these people have created demons, and they have created God and gave him to us to worship. Okay, that's what they have done. See, because I don't see a mighty creating a devil to undo what you've done. People, can you do anything? Can you work any kind of electrical device without there being a positive and a negative wire? That's how God is. God and the devil, they work hand in hand. But man has separated them and has pitted them against each other. Okay. So this man Ammon, he was just nothing but a man who called himself the god of all the other pharaohs. He was protected, constantly protected, the patron god of the pharaohs. Not patron god of gods. Not patron god of, not no creator god. People, all these pharaohs, they were all men. That's what they are, men. They weren't supposed to be worshipped. We do not rank them, we worship them. Okay? From the beginning of time, man has not seen any god but the sun. From the beginning of time. Okay? And it's in the Bible here someplace, but I'm not going to look for it right now because I'm going to mess up. But it's in the Bible. I see it a little while ago. And it's the truth. Okay. So, a message to my friends. Right? I think I've gone on a little bit long and I'm going to probably do a follow-up. So, my friend Mad Killers, Osiris King 1, and Osiris King and Audacity 1, I hope I have at least answered some of your questions. I mean, I know I didn't get all down packed, but I hope I've at least set you on a path where you could start doing your own research, and I will try to do a follow-up. And if you guys have any more questions, don't be afraid to ask me. I'm not going to answer it right away because I'm kind of slow to react to certain things and fast to react to others. So I just move about with the spirit, okay? So if I don't answer you right away, it doesn't mean I'm ignoring you. It just mean the time is not right for me to answer it yet. So I'll do a follow-up on this one, hopefully. You know, the war getting hot. And, so, we know the sun is God, people, okay? I've shown you all many places in the Bible where he said it points to the sun is God. And when I say the sun is God, I don't like the word God because God was a word made up also. I only use God because it's in my vocabulary and it's what you people understand. But the sun is a spiritual, it's our spirit. Okay? I believe the sun from the sun come our spirit, and when we die, we are reincarnated and serious. That's what I believe. Okay, that's what I believe. The serious is our spiritual sun, and our sun is a physical sun, something like that. But I'm gonna get it one day. Okay, I'm gonna share it with you guys. So anyway, this is all for now, people. The sun, I'm not gonna speak for you guys. The sun is my Lord. Until I find the sun and Sirius right now are my lords, and the moon, not the weak moon that we see, but the super full moon, those are my lords and Sirius until I find something else that put me in a different direction. Because I've heard, I heard the voice, people. Okay, this video what you're watching now, I heard the voice, there's a voice in here, but I've issued a challenge to some professionals. I want to decipher this video. Because there's a voice in this video, people, that tell you who's God. But I'm not going to, if I tell you, I showed y'all before and people laughed at me. So I'm going to let one of the professionals take on my challenge. I dare one of you professionals to decipher this video right here. And you're going to hear a voice on there that came from other space. From that moon right there, the voice. From the sun right there, telling you who God is. Okay? So when you are ready to hear the truth, contact me and I'll give you this video and let you decipher it yourself. Let you decipher and you see the truth. It will tell you who God is. People of America and the world, Jesus Christ is not your God. He's not your Savior. He's nothing. This sun that you're looking at, it tells you in a voice on this video who God is. I just turned on the video so I could talk over it to make this video, but I know who God is, who Lord is, who the Lord is. And sooner or later you are going to know too. Actually, people, like I told you, while I was researching, I found another scripture where it proved that God is the Son. And here it is, okay? Isaiah chapter 64. Listen to this keenly. Oh, that you would rend the heaven, that you would come down, that the mountain might shake at your presence. As a fire burns brushwood, as fire causes water to boil, to make your name known to your adversaries, that the nations may tremble at your presence. When you did awesome things for which we did not look, you came down. The mountains shook at your presence. For since the beginning of the world, men have not heard, nor perceived by the ear, nor has the eye seen any God beside you, who act for the one who waits for him. People, do you hear this, people? Let me repeat that. Isaiah chapter 64, verse 4. For since the beginning of time of the world, men have not heard nor perceived any God beside you, who acts for the one who waits for him. Now, people, there's an important thing that sentence I just said, because people from all of you know history, right? Those of you know history, from the beginning of time, men have worshipped several gods. From the beginning of time, but people have all those gods who men have ever worshipped. Which one is still living today? Which God is the only one that you have seen? Which one? You could say Christ is living, but you have never seen him. You could say Jehovah is living, but you have never seen him. So people, of all the gods that you know, that men have ever worshipped, which one has never, ever gone away? Which one has been living from the very beginning of time, when man start writing down stuff, till now? The sun is the only living God, the Alpha. From the beginning of time, man be worshiping the sun, and when time is end, if it ever end, it's gonna still be the sun. From the first time man opens his eyes, if it wasn't for the sun, he would not have been able to see, because the sun would give him the light of his eye. And that's why Egyptians say the right eye is the sun and the left eye is the moon. Because, man, you cannot see without the moon or the sun. All this artificial light, these lampposts, those are artificial lights. But if it wasn't for the sun and the moon, if it wasn't for the artificial lights and the sun in the day and the moon by night, you would be in total darkness. Total darkness. So let me repeat that. Forget about all the artificial light. If it wasn't for the sun by day, mankind will never, ever, ever be able to see anything. So that means the sun is your eye. The sun is your eye. The sun is your God. Because without that, you can't see. And in the night, the moon is your eye. If it wasn't for the moon, any artificial light, you will not see nothing in the night. Forget about the stars. I'm talking about what could give you light. So you see, people, that's what Egyptians saw. That's why they said the sun. And I mean, actually, that's truth. Because from the first thing when you were born, you open your eyes. If you weren't for the light, you wouldn't be able to see anything. And before time, they didn't have this bulb. It was the sunlight and the moon. So the moon is a man's eye by night, and the sun is the eye by day. But what these popes have done, they have pit man left eye against his right eye. They have pit day against night. That's what they have done. They have confused us. They have pit us against each other. People, when you just so claim devil tell you to do something wrong, where that thought come from? Doesn't God come from there to tell you to do right? Your evil thoughts, any good thoughts come from the same exact source. Because you are God and you're the devil. You don't fight against it. You are binary. That's why I say you got bipolar sometimes. It's not bipolar. You have two personalities. You're just fighting against them. Some people are able to balance their dual personalities. So that's what it is. The sun, people, is your god. Without the sun, you cannot see. Without the moon, you cannot see. Without the sun, you cannot have no food. Without the sun, the air would freeze up and fall to the ground as ice. The sun is your god. It keeps you alive. Okay? And when you're dead, your soul are reincarnated and serious. That's what I believe. So anyway, for since the beginning of the world, men have not heard, nor perceived by the ear, nor have the eye seen any god beside you, who act for the one who waits for him. And now, to end it, let me go to Revelations. If Revelations don't prove God is the Son, then where's he gonna get it from? Okay, Revelation chapter 1. Now, people, first let me ask you a question. Remember, I asked you about comparing Elijah to Xavier. Now we know, people. Let's say, right, I also have a diamond and a platinum, and I'm comparing something else to them. Let's say the stuff I'm comparing is okay. Let's say I have a piece of glass and I have a piece of diamond, and I'm doing comparison. Which one would I use to make a comparison? Would I use the diamond? Sorry, because the diamond is more precious than the glass. So I would say, wow, ain't this piece of glass like diamond to me? I'm not gonna say ain't this diamond like a piece of glass, because glass is worthless. So now, this is what I wanna say to you now. Revelation chapter 1, verse 13. And in the midst of the seven lampstands, one like the Son of Man, clothed with a garment down to the feet. Okay, let me start that over. Then I turned to see the voice that spoke with me, and having turned, I saw seven golden lampstands, and in the midst of the seven lampstands, one like the Son of Man, clothed with a garment down to his feet, and girt about the chest with a golden band. His head and hair was white like wool, as white as snow, and his eyes like a flame of fire. Okay. His feet were like fine brass, as if refined in a furnace, and his voice as the sound of many waters. He had in his right hand seven stars. Out of his mouth went a sharp two-edged sword, and his countenance was like the sun shining in its strength. Now, people, this is a comparison. His countenance was like the sun. He's talking about the Messiah here. His countenance was like the sun. Now, people, what light in this world can you compare the sun to? Nothing. So the sun is the supreme light. I don't care you talk about all these bigger suns way out in the galaxy. Who gives a damn? Have you ever seen those suns with your naked eye? Have you ever felt their heat? How do you know they're not just gas bubbles? Look like they are shining from the sun. So people are always talking about, oh, there's so many suns out there. You have never seen them. NASA told you that. You have never seen them. Stop lying. Okay? And if there's more suns out there, which I don't doubt, they are. But how do you know they're not just gas giants? Useless masses. Just because they're suns don't mean they can bear life. Okay? So our sun bear life. So our sun could be more mature than all those other suns. Are more developed than the other sun. So just because our sun is so small, don't underestimate it. Small axe cut down big tree. Remember that. So anyway, there's no light in the universe you compare but the sun. So if you say that the Messiah, if you say to me that he had in his right hand 7 stars. Who hold the fucking stars? Who hold the stars? The sun, people. The sun hold the stars in its gravity. He had in his right hand 7 stars. As if a man could really hold stars in his hand. And out of his mouth went a sharp two-edged sword, which is lightning. And his countenance was like the sun, shining in its strength. See, people, the sun shining in its strength, which means that the sun is more powerful than its God, because he said his countenance is like the sun, shining in its strength. So, the Bible, John here, is comparing the Messiah to the sun. Okay? Not comparing the sun to him, but comparing him to the sun. So that means, people, aren't you like the people of Ethiopia to me, O children of Israel? Aren't you like the sun to me, Jesus Christ? Aren't you like the sun to me, Sirius? He's telling you the sun is the Almighty, and this man in the Bible, the Messiah, is the son of the sun. Okay? He had in his right hand 7 stars, and out of his mouth went a sharp two-edged sword. And his countenance was like the sun, shining in his strength. Okay? He is like the sun. It's a comparison, which means the sun is his father. It's comparing him. Okay? Now let's go to Revelation chapter 10 now. I saw still another mighty angel coming down from heaven, clothed with a cloud, and a rainbow was on his head. Here we go again with the rainbow. People who carries around a rainbow? The sun. Okay, the sun is the one who carries a rainbow, not the stars. The sun. I saw still another mighty angel come down from heaven, clothed with a cloud, and a rainbow was on his head. His face was like the sun. His face is like the sun. Listen to that. Okay. And his feet like pillars of fire. Okay. His feet like pillars of fire. Okay. Okay, I'm going to skip to chapter 10 verse 4 say, and when he cried, 7 thunders uttered their voice. Okay? When he cries, 7 thunders utter their voice. Oh, people, they're talking about the stars and the moon and the sun and the cloud, not no man. Every reference I showed you before, sun, lightning, rainbow, and clouds, and thunder. So, if y'all wanna go and think that,
oh my God,
that somebody kill a son and put the son on the cross and buried him in the ground for 3 days and that son rose for you. If you really believe that bullshit, then guess what? You deserve what's coming towards you, God. That's just what you're gonna reap. That's the reality. If you believe in that reality, that's the reality you're gonna reap. And guess what? You're gonna be Jesus' slave for the rest of your eternity. One love, my people. And my friend, Osiris King, Mad Killers, and Audacity One, I hope I've at least, you know, answered your question. And people, one love, okay? More to come soon. Alright.